New South Wales might boast the biggest economy in the country, but there's proof tonight that biggest is not always best. Two new studies have slammed the poor state of our state, especially a chronic housing shortage.
It's the premier state, harbouring an unenviable position. As weak economic growth, slow retail spending, and a housing shortage combine to leave New South Wales ranked as Australia's worst performing state.
Well, New South Wales economy is missing that X factor, that factor which drives growth.
Our booming population is both our greatest strength and greatest weakness.
In Sydney, not enough units and freestanding houses are being created, so you've got tight supply, you've got high demand, and that's keeping prices relatively high.
Across the state, a study has found 300,000 households suffer housing stress.
People on the lowest 40% of incomes who are paying more than 30% of that income in housing costs.
Anglicare reports growing numbers of homeless in Sydney and is being inundated with emergency calls for help.
Particularly young women, single women without housing needs, with supporting children, that is a huge issue for us.
Elected in March with a sweeping mandate for change, some are now asking when the O'Farrell government will take tangible steps to turn the state's housing crisis around.
Barry O'Farrell said he would move the state forward. He's moving the state forward, but at a snail's pace.
We really need significant ongoing investment in this area.
Anglicare has high hopes for the second O'Farrell budget. Jacqueline Maddock, 10 News.